Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video I'll be explaining you about analysis of a continuous beam using slope deflection method when the support is sinking. Okay, so I have an overhang beam with the loading acting on it, and here he is telling that support B is sinking by 15 mm. Okay, the support B is sinking down with 15 mm of displacement. He has given us the values of E and I. He is asking us to analyze this. So analyzing means you need to calculate the final moments and you need to calculate the net bending moment. Okay, right. Let's start off with the problem. In slope deflection method, our first step will be always writing the fixed end moments. So let's start for span AB. For every span, you'll be having two moments, one in clock direction and the other in anti-clock direction. So I'll start off with, so you have your span AB and you have span BC. So for AB you'll be getting two moments, for BC you'll be getting two moments, so finally there'll be four, and you have one moment which is coming at D. Alright, so you'll have total of five. So first is m bar AB is for span AB, which is an anti-clock direction. You have a point load which is eccentric, so the formula is minus WAB square by L square. Why we have put a minus is MAB is in anti-clock direction. So minus 100 into 4 into 2 square by 6 square, which is minus 44.44 kilonewton meter. Next we have MBA. The form MBA is acting like this, which is in clock direction. The formula is WA square B by L square. 100 into A is this distance 4. 4 square into B is this distance 2 by 6 square. 88.88. Next comes m bar bc is again anti-clock direction, so minus, it's having a UDL, so the formula is WL square by 12, so minus 20 into 5 square by 12 is this value. Next comes m bar cb is in a clock direction, which is WL square by 12, which is 20 into 5 square by 12, 41.67 kilonewton meter. Next we have m bar cd is 20 into 1.5. C2D is anti-clock moment, so minus 20 into 1.5, force into perpendicular distance, so minus 30 kilonewton meter. This is how we'll finish off the step 1. Our step 2 will be writing the slope deflection equations. So we have the formula MAB equal to M bar AB plus 2 EI by L into 2 theta A plus theta B minus 3 delta by L. Here MAB equal to M bar AB, just now we got from, so minus 44.44 plus 2 EI by span of AB 6 into theta A is 0. Why? Because end A is fixed. Theta B minus 3 into, here we are having delta. So when you are doing for the span AB, here it's given in the question that B is sinking. So I'll tell you a sign convention. Remember, when you are taking span AB, here our support B is on the right hand side. So when you are considering any span, in that span, if your sinking support is on the right hand side, just substitute the given displacement. Okay, our displacement was given as 15 mm, so convert into meters, it is 0.015 meters, 15 by 1000. Directly substitute that value in the place of delta. Okay, when you are doing for span BC, so in the span BC, B is on the left hand side, the sinking support is on the left hand side, right? So when you are substituting for delta, substitute minus 0.015. okay, yeah. So 3 into 0.015 by 6. I'm not substituting the values of A and I. Why? Because it all becomes a big equation, clumsy equation. So I'll not substitute. So that I'll continue the same process. I'll calculate EI theta B and EI theta C. Then I'll be calculating MAB easily. So finally, our equation will turn out to be minus 44.44 plus EI by 3 theta B minus 0.015 by 6 EI. Next, I'll solve for MBA, M bar BA plus 2 EI by L into 2 theta B plus theta A minus 3 delta by L. MBA from step 1, 88.88 plus 2 EI by 6 into 2 theta B. This is already 0, minus 3 into 0.015 by 6. So MBA is this equation, which is 2. I'll not substitute any values of E and I now. I'll substitute in the last step. Next, we'll write for MBC, M bar BC plus 2 EI by L into 2 theta B plus theta C minus 3 delta by L. I've told you one sign convention, you have to be careful here. In BC, B is on to the left side, so substitute minus of minus. So, substitute a value of M bar BC, substitute the values of L, 2 theta B, theta C, and 3 into minus of 0.015 by 5. Okay, so you'll be getting M bar BC. That will be our equation number 3. Next is MCB, which is M bar CB plus 2EI by L into 2 theta C plus theta B minus 3 delta by L. Same again, substitute the value of M bar CB from step 1. Then solve for substitute the values of delta as minus. Why? Because in BC span, B is on the left side. So you'll be resulting in the equation, which is 4. MCD is already M bar CD, which is minus 30. Next comes our step 3, which is equilibrium condition application. So we have joint B. For joint B to be in equilibrium, you should make a moment which is going from B towards the left side plus moment which is going towards right side should be added and equal to 0. So MBA plus MBC is 0. So MBA is given by equation number 2. MBC is given by equation number 3. Just add them and equal to 0. Finally, you will be getting this equation. Now we can calculate the value of E and I, but only here for this numerical. Okay, not EI theta B and EI theta C. Here you substitute, you'll be resulting in this equation, which is equation number 6. Similarly, at joint C also, I'll apply the condition MCB plus MCD equal to 0. Again, add the both the equations and make it to 0. Then in the place here, yeah, you'll be left with 11.67 plus this equation. Substitute the values of E and I for this numerical. Then you'll be resulting in this equation, which is 7. So solve for equation 6 and 7. Why? Because you have only two equations, you have only two unknowns. You'll get the value of EI theta B as minus 31.33, EI theta C as minus 9.71. Your variable may vary, your decimal may vary at little bit, but it should be closer to this value. So after getting the values of your slopes, you can substitute the slopes in equations right from 1, 2, 3, 4. You'll get final moments. That will be our step number 4. So after substituting the values of EI theta B and EI theta C and E and I values also in all the four equations, I got MAB as minus 60.88, MBA 62, MBC minus 62, MCB 30 and MCD as minus 30 already there. So in all in kilonewton meter, you can observe at a joint B we applied equilibrium condition, so BA plus BC became 0. Similarly at C also we applied plus 30 minus 30 became 0. In order to complete the bending moment diagram with respect to, I mean, other than these final moments, I also require the bending moments due to the given loading. In the span AB I had a eccentric point load, so the bending moment diagram will be a triangle with the ordinate or height of the triangle as WAB by L, which is 100 into 4 into 2 by 6, 133.33 kilonewton meter. Similarly, in the bending moment in the span BC, it's a UDL, so the bending moment diagram will be a parabola with height WL square by 8, so 20 into 5 square by 8 is 62.5. Next, in order to, so this values are enough for me to complete the bending moment diagram. So let's see the bending moment diagram once, then I'll explain you about shear force diagram. Right, this is our bending moment diagram. So first MAB is minus 60.88, I have marked. MBA and MBC are same, 62. Then MCD 30 I got. So first you mark this 60.88. from here to here you join with a straight line, again from here to here you join with a straight line, and again you join. First complete the bending moment diagram with respect to final moments, then let's complete the bending moment diagram with respect to given loading. I already told you it's a triangle, so this is a triangle, and below this 100 kilonewton draw the height as 133.33. okay, mark here. Next, bending moment in BC was 62.5, so mark 62.5 here and draw a parabola. So this is negative, this is positive, this is negative, this is positive, this is negative. So shared whichever is left over, this all got subtracted. We are left with the net bending moment. This shaded part is your net bending moment. Now let's go for the shear force. So in order to draw the shear force diagram, you require the support reactions. So for calculation of support reactions, consider the spans individually. So consider the span AB. So I have marked AB values, MAB, MBA. Don't forget the moments. And RA plus RB is 100. Taking moments about A, minus RP into 6 plus 100 into 4 plus MBA minus MAB. Substitute the values, you will be getting RA, RB. I am repeating once again, don't substitute MAB as minus of minus 60.88. Okay, here MAB is 60.88 in magnitude. There why we got minus is because it is anti-clock moment. So when you are substituting here, don't substitute. Since it's minus AB, don't substitute minus of minus. Why you got minus AB? Why? Because it is anti-clock direction. So just only substitute the magnitude. Then consider the span BC. RB plus RC is 20 × 500. Take moments about B. Minus RC into 5 plus 20 into 5 into 5 by 2. Why? Because it's a UDL considered to be in the form of a rectangle. Total load is 20 into 5. Centroidal distance will be into 5 by 2. Plus MCB minus MB is equal to 0. The moment coming from the overhang portion is also already considered here as MCB. So you need not do it again. So just substitute the values, you get RC and RB. So now this is quite sufficient for us to start this SFD. So see here. First you draw the line. Now I am following the sign convention of RUN LUP. Right side upward negative, left side upward positive. Okay. So let me start with the span AB. For span AB, I got REA as 33.15. REA is on the left side upward positive. So I have drawn 33.15 upward. So I'll come till here. Here I add 100. So 100 minus 100 plus 33.55 will result in 66.85. Or else you have already here RB. RB means right side upward negative, it will again come here only. Like this our shear force diagram will be. Let's consider the shear force diagram for span BC. I got RB 56.4, right side upward negative. Left side upward positive. RBC, no, BC is up, left side. Left side upward positive 56.4. Next, RC 43.6. RUN, right side upward negative. Then here, we are expecting a high ordinate for parabola, so which means our shear force must change the sign, so join like this. And at D we had 20 kN acting downwards. When right side upward is negative, then right side downward will be positive, so join like this. So this will be our shear force diagram. You can still continue the problem. You can calculate the maximum bending moment in the span BC. Take this distance as x, so this distance will be 5 minus x. So this triangle look like similar triangles, so x by 5 minus x is equal to 43.6 by 56.4. You'll get the value of x. So at a distance of that meters from C, you get a maximum bending moment. Actually, it should be at the center, but due to the effect of end moments or final moments, it may not be exactly at the center. Okay, this is how you need to solve. So when coming to sinking, you have to remember majorly the sign convention. When your sinking support is towards the right hand side, you have to put the same value, given displacement value. But when your sinking support is on the left hand side in the span whichever you are considering, then you have to put minus of minus. Okay, hope you understood this video, and thank you.